Within hours, Adelaide drivers caught by new mobile phone cameras will be made to fork out hundreds of dollars.
Almost 70,000 warnings have been dished out in just 3 months, and shockingly, several motorists have been snapped more than 30 times.
This is what some drivers think of the new mobile phone cameras: a blatant disregard for the law or a joke. But either way,
I can tell you the fun's over. From tonight, you're copping a fine, and you're going to cop multiple fines if you continue to engage in that type of behaviour.
Staggering new figures show almost 70,000 SA drivers were busted during the three-month trial. One driver caught red-handed 33 times. Picture proof shows one motorist with a hand on a burger, one on the phone, another using a seatbelt as a phone holder.
I can tell you that's an offence. Held means held on any part of your body.
And while all five cameras are expected to be money spinners, new stats show the Regency Park site is snapping the most offences, with 19,000 warning letters sent out, followed by Torrensville, Jepps Cross, Hindmarsh and Darlington. If the official switch on doesn't deter driver behaviour, there will be plenty off the road.
There would have been over 1,200 people during this grace period that would have lost their licence.
And tens of thousands forced to cough up the $658 fine. But the message from police is clear.
I encourage every motorist in South Australia, do not use your phone while you're driving. It is so simple. Just don't do it.
Hannah Ford, 7 News.
And Hannah, more cameras are on the way.
That's right, Rosanna. As these cameras begin generating revenue, there are plans for others to come online. Two new locations are set to be revealed by police early next year, but there will be plenty of warning, just like there has been this time round. Police have now rolled out warning signage for all of the five cameras already in use, so there's no excuse. Officers are reminding drivers that just touching your phone, even in a cradle or on the passenger seat, is an offence, but they're hoping now that the cameras are officially on, fewer drivers will be caught doing the wrong thing. Figures on the number of drivers caught over the first few days of the operation are expected to be released by police in a week's time.